Someone had to turn the computer on to type the message, "Sorry, you are the only one who deserved to stay." The computer would not note the time the message itself was typed, but the switch-on time could be determined. The defense camp said timings showed David could not have returned home in time to turn on the computer, so it must have been Robin who typed the message and was therefore the killer. David was, the defense said, seen by an independent witness outside his house after the computer turn-on time, which gave him a cast-iron defense. However, this case was no different to most complicated murders. Exact timings would be elusive and scenarios pliable. The Bain family's computer was in an alcove off the lounge at the front of the house. It sat on some planks propped up by a length of tree trunk and some wood offcuts. Green curtains screened off the computer alcove from the lounge, a room which seemed to be used only for receiving visitors and prayer meetings. Clearly, the writer of the message was the killer, and examining what the computer could tell the investigation was a good piece of police work, as, back in 1994, desktop computers and laptops were not yet the fixture of domestic life they would become, nor indeed were they as complex and swift as the machines of today. Police on the Bain investigation called in University of Otago computer scientist Martin Cox to help analyze the computer. On the day after the murders, and with Detective Kevin Anderson taking notes, Cox went through an exercise designed to see how long the computer had been running since it was last turned on. He could then work back to finding the switch-on time. The killer had left the computer running, and so had the police, so the message was still on the computer screen when Cox began his work.